Welcome to Skyview Acres. This is our farm. We have about 10 acres, and we came up with the name Skyview because that is the road that my husband grew up on in North Carolina. We love this place. We've been here about a year and a half, but we really haven't been able to do anything farm-like yet, so we're getting ready to finally start that adventure. We are looking at all the different things that are involved in homesteading. We are hoping to get some farm equipment so that we can mow our pasture. We are hoping to look at some solar energy to help us be more off the grid. We are hoping to have a garden with lots of fruits and vegetables, and we are hoping to have an orchard. We're also going to use that barn for goats and chickens. It already has a chicken coop in it. So we've got to rebuild it and kind of make it strong, but it already has that in there. And we might even board some horses at some point. So we're very excited about this new adventure, and we're gonna take you with us every step of the way.
Good morning. Welcome to the barn. It's a nice November morning, nice and brisk. Beautiful day out here in the country. Thought I'd come down to the barn and just do a little bit of brainstorming on what our projects are going to be. Thought I'd just give you a walkthrough while we're here. So here we go. This barn has 3 horse stalls in it. And as you can tell, it's kind of a mess right now. We've had the farm for a little while. Haven't really done anything down here yet. Other than the store stuff, we're planning on putting a chicken coop in. There was one here at one point. But we've got lots of work to do. We've got to get the power sorted out. There's some kind of an issue I'm trying to figure out with it as to why it won't work. Here's one of the horse stalls that doesn't have a bunch of junk in it yet. Down here, you've got 2 more. We'll go over here where we're going to put the chicken coop. Somebody's had one at one point, but we've taken out a little bit of it and it wasn't in really good shape. It's just made with chicken wire, which had obviously gotten ripped in a couple of places because they tried to stitch it back up. Doesn't do a good job of keeping predators out at all. But we'll have a coop in here. It's already got the door that'll go out to the run, which we're gonna build outside. I'll take out there here in just a minute. All right, so here's what we're looking at for our coop. The stall area is 12 by 12, which according to the calculations I've seen online, ought to be plenty big for the 15 chickens we're planning on starting out with and give us room to expand. Like I said, they're gonna have a run outside, but this 12 by 12 area will be their coop for at night. Obviously, we got lots of work to do on it because it's not predator proof, especially being as one of our lovely groundhogs has already decided to make a tunnel for everybody into it. So lots of work to be done. As you can see, with it being in the barn, it's going to be sheltered. We'll put up some siding for in the winter to keep the draft down so they don't get cold, but it's going to have plenty of ventilation, so we're not going to have to worry about condensation or anything like that. Opens up to the hayloft up above. So I think it's gonna work out quite well. All right, let's start it on. Pulling all the old chicken wire off. Had a bunch of tools and an old shelf here, so I gotta get my drill and take the rest of that off if I can. Screws are stripped out really bad on it. This kind of shows you why you don't use chicken wire on a chicken coop. It is not predator proof. You can just rip it apart by hand. It just rips. It's good for keeping chickens somewhere, but not good for keeping things away from them. Anyway, got started on ripping this out. It's gonna take a while. I have to get Zach down here to help me, and Kerrigan probably, but it's a good start. It's gonna be a good size coop. Looking really forward to it. Alright, here we go. Got one little bit left up there of chicken wire to pull down, but I don't have a ladder down here today. But that's all the chicken wire down. I'd say that's a good start for 45 minutes of work. Anyway, that's progress. As you can see, we still got some work to do outside too. Cleaning up the pastures that have gotten kind of overgrown. We got several acres. So eventually we'll have goats, chickens, ducks, hopefully some bees, and maybe even eventually some horses. Stay tuned. We'll put up some more videos as we go through the process. And you can follow along on what we're doing here on the farm. Have a good one.